I really want to share this kind of question. Check this out. We have a smartphone, it's now $500, and that's after a 20% discount. The question is, we would like to know what was its original price. So go ahead, pause the video and try this first. Dan, let me tell you, this kind of question is a very classic percentage question that so many students get it wrong. So let me show you guys the common mistake first. A lot of students will just take the 500 times the 20% first. And let me put that down right here. 500 and multiply by 20%. 20% is the same as 0.2 by moving the decimal twice to the left. Always change a percentage to a decimal when you multiply. So if you do this, you will end up 100 right here. 20% of 500 is 100. And then they will just add this and that together. It seems okay, right? 500 plus this number, and at the end, we get 600. So this right here should just be the original price, right? No, in fact, this is not correct. The reason is because we are taking 20% of the original. And here, we are doing the 20% of the sale price. No. Another way to look at this is the following. If you take $600 as the original price, and let me just write this down, and if you multiply this by 20%, which is again 0.2, you will end up $120. And then if you start with the original $600 and then minus the $120, you will end up $480. This is not the same as the $500 that we are looking for. So this is not correct. So how exactly do we do it? Here, let me show you guys a fast way. The key is the 20% discount. So now let's think about it. What exactly does the 20% discount do for us? Well, originally, we will have to pay for the full price, right? And what percentage is the full amount? The answer to that is 100%. And let me draw a picture for you guys right here. Let's say this right here is 100%. But now, we have a 20% discount. So you can just think about it like, okay, you don't have to pay that 20% right here anymore. So what percent do we have to pay? The remaining is what? 80%, right? Because together we have to get 100%. So when we have a 20% discount, this means we pay 80% of the original. And now, let's think about it. 80% of the original, which is the sales price, which is 500. So how can we figure out the original? Well, 80% of means we multiply. 80% times the original gives us 500. So if I want to figure out the original, just go ahead and do $500 right here. Divide, because we have to do backwards, divided by 80%, which is 0.8 by moving the decimal twice to the left. All right. Okay, just real quick, 500 divided by 0.8. Let's use long division. And remember, the first number goes inside and the second number goes on the outside. So that's the setup. But for the outside number, we don't want to have a decimal. So change that. We just have to move the decimal point one time to the right. And for the inside, you just put a zero because we moved the decimal point one time to the right. Now we can do K8 and 50. 8 goes into 50 six times. 6 times 8 is 48. And then subtract. 50 minus 48 is 2. And bring down the zero. And then look at 8 and 20. Well, 8 goes into 20 two times. 2 times 8 is 16. And again, we subtract. We'll get 4. And then finally, bring down this zero. And right here, we will just have what? 8 and 40. 8 goes into 40 five times. 5 times 8 is 40, and the remainder is 0. So the answer right here is 625. And now let's go ahead and check our answer. Take 20% of 625, so just multiply 625 with 0.2, and we get 125. And then we do 625 minus 125, and we do end up with $500. And that's the correct answer. So hopefully this right here is clear. And before we go though, here's a question for you guys to try. Go ahead and try it and leave your answer in the comment and let me know what you get. That's it.